Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Here I am explaining you the video series on the topic bubble sort. In this video series I have covered the topics right from introduction to the execution of the program. Before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. In this video session, I am explaining you the execution of the algorithm which is called as dry run with the help of solved example. In the previous video, we have seen that how to develop a logic or an algorithm for bubble sort, and now the same algorithm we are going to use to execute it, to explain it with the help of solved example. So here the left half slide is I am going to use to show you the algorithm or the program, and the right half slide in which I will show you the dry run with the help of solved example. So let's start with the first statement of our algorithm, where we are going to start with the first pass for I equal to 0. So let's start with the pass 1 and the first iteration in which we are going to compare the first pair of the elements. So let's start with I equal to 0. Then for the next for loop, for j equal to 0, let's initialize the j with the value 0, and now let's go forward for the next statement of your algorithm is nothing but the comparison. So let's compare the element which is present at jth position and j plus 1 position. Whether the condition is true? Yes, the condition is true. So that's why this is j and j plus 1. And now, as if the condition is true, what we have to do? We have to go forward for the next statement of our slide, which is nothing but the swapping of two numbers. So for the swapping of two numbers, here you can see that I have used a temporary variable. So let's take this container as a temporary variable, and what you have to do, you have to put the jth element into the temporary variable. So this temporary variable is now holding the value 22. Now let's paste the value of j plus 1 at the jth position. So I have pasted it. And now the j plus 1 position will hold the value from the temporary variable. So now let's update the j plus 1 position. So in this way we have done the swapping of the elements of the current pair, which is highlighted now with the help of window. And after swapping, you can see that the number 22, which is higher in a weight, is located at the end of the pair. So this was the iteration 1. Now let's move forward for the next iteration, and for the next iteration your I will be as it is, that is 0, and now the inner for loop j plus plus will be there. Here you can see that now j will be pointed at the next position, that is nothing but the first position, and the next position that I am going to compare is nothing but j plus 1. So let's highlight the window with the help of let's highlight the pair with the help of window, and now let's compare both of them. Whether the condition is true or false? Yes, the condition is true. It means that we have to perform the swapping between two numbers. Why the condition is true? Because jth element is higher in the weight than that of j plus 1 element, and as we want to sort these numbers in ascending order, these two numbers must get swapped with each other. Now for the swapping, what we have to do? Again, we have to take the help of temporary variable. Let's copy the jth element into the temporary variable. Let's copy the j plus 1 element at the jth position, and let's copy the content of a temporary variable at the j plus 1 position. And in this way, we have done the swapping of these two numbers in second iteration. After this, what we have to do? Again, we will go back to perform j plus plus operation in the iteration number 3. So let's perform j plus plus operation. Let's initialize j to the second position. Let's initialize j plus 1 to the position 3. Let's compare whether 22 and 15 is it needed to perform the swapping by comparing whether 22 is greater than 15. Yes, it's needed. So that's why what we have to do now. Let's highlight these two elements, then perform the swapping of these two numbers with the help of temporary variable. Let's copy the jth element onto the temporary variable. Let's copy j plus 1 element onto the jth position and the temporary variable at the j plus 1 position. And in this way, we have done with the swapping. And at the end of this iteration, you can see the higher weight element is residing at the end position of the pair. So now let's move forward for the next iteration 4, by performing j plus plus. Let's initialize j. After that, let's compare j and j plus 1. Again, the swapping is needed as the 22 is greater than 2. So highlight the pair and let's swap the elements with the temporary variable. And after swapping the elements from the temporary variable and j plus 1, you can see the array will look like this. And at the end of the pass 1, here you can see that the greatest number among these numbers is secured the last position, and all the numbers which are lighter in weight are bubbled up. Now let's move forward for the next pass and the iteration. So pass number 2 and the iteration 1. For that, here let's perform I plus plus and I is incremented by 1. Let's start again from initialize j to 0 position. Let's initialize j. Let's compare and j plus 1. The condition is false, so that's why no swapping is needed. Let's highlight the pair first of all, and let's look at the elements which are present in the highlighted pair. No swapping is needed, so that's why move forward for the next iteration. Let's perform j plus plus, and now let's initialize j to 1, and let's compare the elements which are adjacent to each other. Highlight the pair again, as 18 is greater than 15 and we want to sort the numbers in ascending order, the swapping is needed, so that's why let's highlight the line of code which we are going to execute. That is nothing but the swapping. Let's copy the jth element into the temporary variable. Let's copy j plus 1 element at the jth position, and let's copy the temporary variable at the j plus 1 position. So swapping is done, and now let's move forward for the next iteration 3, by performing j plus plus operation. As the condition is true, let's move forward for the comparison j and j plus 1, and let's highlight the pair here. And after highlighting, you can see that the 18 is greater than 2, so that's why swapping is needed. So let's highlight the swapping code and let's perform the swapping of these two numbers. And after that, let's move forward for the next iteration. Let's highlight the pair now, and after highlighting, no need of swapping. So that's why at the end of pass 2, you can see over here the 18 is also secured the second last position. Here you must have seen that we have compared with the 22 as well, and this is the disadvantage of this algorithm, as though the numbers are in order, still we have to perform the comparison between each and every element of the array. Let's start with the next pass number 3 and the first iteration. That's why I is 2 and j equal to 0. Let's compare the first pair, and the no swapping is needed, so that's why increment in j. In the second iteration, j is initialized at 1. Let's compare both the elements. Yes, the swapping is needed as 15 is greater than 2. Let's perform the swapping of these two numbers with the temporary variable. And after swapping, you can see over here the elements are looking like this. Let's move forward for the next iteration. Let's compare 15 and 18. No swapping is needed. because 15 is less than 18, they are already in supposed to ascending order. So that's why next iteration J++, let's compare 18 and 22, again they are in order, so that's why no swapping is needed. At the end of pass 3, you can see the three numbers are settled down at the bottom position of the array. Let's go forward for the last pass, as the 5 numbers are present, so n-1 number of passes are required. This will be the last pass. And for the iteration 1, let's initialize J to 0. Let's compare J and J+1. As the 12 is greater than 2, the swapping is needed. Let's perform the swapping of these two numbers, and after swapping, this will look like this. Let's move forward for the next iteration. Let's compare these two values. As they are in order, no swapping is needed. Let's move forward for the next iteration. Let's highlight the elements with the window, and no swapping is needed as they are already in a sorted way. Let's move forward for the next iteration. Let's initialize, increment J to the next position, and let's compare J to the +1 position. Highlight the window, and here you can see that no swapping is needed, so that's why this is at the end of pass 4. You can see the last 4 numbers have secured their position. Now the number 2 is remaining for the comparison, but as you can see that among 5, 4 number has secured the position. It indicates that a single number is also in a sorted order. So that's why we'll require the n-1 number of passes if n number of elements are present in your array. So in this way, the bubble sort algorithm is executed, and I have explained you it with the help of example. I hope you must have understood all the things. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the video and the content, please do not forget to give the comment, and do not forget to share it with your friends. Here I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel Tech Talks. Along with this, the next video of this video series you will find out here, as well as the whole video series you can find here with the help of playlist of a bubble sort. Thank you. Happy data structuring. Happy learning. Thank you.